There are people who the more you do for them, the less they will do for themselves. There is no charm equal to tenderness of heart. I wish, as well as everybody else, to be perfectly happy, but, like everybody else, it must be in my own way. Perhaps it is our imperfections that make us so perfect for one another. A mind lively and at ease with itself is content to look at nothing, and that nothing will always answer back. In life, bad characters often thrive. We, women, love longest even when all hope is gone. I have been meditating on the very great pleasure which a pair of fine eyes in the face of a pretty woman can bestow. There is nothing like staying at home for real comfort. There are many forms of love as there are moments in time. There is nothing I would not do for those who are really my friends. I have no notion of loving people by halves, it is not my nature. Life seems but a quick succession of busy nothings. I always deserve the best treatment because I never put up with any other. But there are not so many men of large fortune in the world as there are pretty women to deserve them. My heart is, and always will be, yours. I declare, after all, there is no enjoyment like reading. How much sooner one tires of anything than of a book. When I have a house of my own, I shall be miserable if I have not an excellent library. Completely and perfectly incandescently happy. I must keep to my own style and go in on my own way, and though I may never succeed again in that, I am convinced that I shall totally fail in any other. A lady's imagination is very rapid. It jumps from admiration to love, from love to matrimony in a moment. Better be without sense than misapply it as you do. We all have our best guides within us, if only we would listen. Now I must give one smirk and then we may be rational again. All I want in a man is somehow who rides bravely, dances beautifully, sings with vigor, reads passionately, and whose taste agrees in every point with mine. Time will explain. Men have had every advantage of us in telling their own story. Education has been theirs in so much higher a degree, the pen has been in their hands. I will not allow books to prove anything. The more I know of the world, the more I am convinced that I shall never see a man whom I can really love. I require so much. She attracted him more than he liked. Her heart did whisper that he had done it for her. You must be the best judge of your own happiness. There could have been no two hearts so open, no tastes so similar, no feelings so in unison. You have qualities which I had not before supposed to exist in such a degree in any human creature. You have some touches of the angel in you. It is a truth universally acknowledged that a single man in possession of a good fortune must be in want of a wife. To be fond of dancing was a certain step towards falling in love. I cannot fix on the hour, or the spot, or the look, or the words, which laid the foundation. It is too long ago. I was in the middle before I knew that I had begun. If a book is well written, I always find it too short. The enthusiasm of a woman's love is even beyond the biographers. A lady, without a family, was the very best preserver of furniture in the world. But Catherine did not know her own advantages, did not know that a good-looking girl, with an affectionate heart and a very ignorant mind, cannot fail of attracting a clever young man, unless circumstances are particularly untoward. Know your own happiness. You want nothing but patience, or give it a more fascinating name, call it hope. The distance is nothing when one has a motive. The person, be it gentleman or lady, who has not pleasure in a good novel, must be intolerably stupid. A large income is the best recipe for happiness I ever heard of. One half of the world cannot understand the pleasures of the other. If adventures will not befall a young lady in her own village, she must seek them abroad. If I loved you less, I might be able to talk about it more. But you know what I am. You hear nothing but truth from me. Silly things do cease to be silly if they are done by sensible people in an impudent way. But people themselves alter so much, that there is something new to be observed in them forever. How much sooner one tires of anything than of a book. To sit in the shade on a fine day and look upon verdure is the most perfect refreshment. What is right to be done cannot be done too soon. She longed to know what at the moment was passing in his mind, in what manner he thought of her, and whether, in defiance of everything, she was still dear to him. Ah. There is nothing like staying at home, for real comfort. She had spoken it, but she trembled when it was done, conscious that her words were listened to, and daring not even to try to observe their effect. A girl likes to be crossed a little in love now and then. I declare, after all, there is no enjoyment like reading. How much sooner one tires of anything than of a book. When I have a house of my own, I shall be miserable if I have not an excellent library. I do not want people to be very agreeable, as it saves me the trouble of liking them a great deal. Wisdom is better than wit, and in the long run will certainly have the laugh on her side. I am now convinced that I have never been much in love, for had I really experienced that pure and elevating passion, I should at present detest his very name, and wish him all manner of evil. But my feelings are not only cordial towards him, they are even impartial towards her. I cannot find out that I hate her at all, or that I am in the least unwilling to think her a very good sort of girl. There can be no love in all this. There is a stubbornness about me that never can bear to be frightened at the will of others. My courage always rises at every attempt to intimidate me. Angry people are not always wise. Strange things may be generally accounted for if their cause be fairly searched out. Nobody minds having what is good for them. A woman is not to marry a man merely because she is asked, or because he is attached to her, and can write a tolerable letter. It is very often nothing but our own vanity that deceives us. I dream of a love that even time will lie down and be still for. When I fall in love, it will be forever. I am determined that only the deepest love will induce me into matrimony. So, I shall end an old maid, and teach your 10 children to embroider cushions and play their instruments very ill. I must learn to be content with being happier than I deserve. What are men compared to rocks and mountains? Run mad as often as you choose, but do not faint. We have all a better guide in ourselves, if we would attend to it, than any other person can be. Listen no longer in silence. I must speak to you by such means as are within my reach. You pierce my soul. I am half agony, half hope. I have loved none but you. Which of all my important nothings shall I tell you first? Those who do not complain are never pitied. Happiness in marriage is entirely a matter of chance. In vain have I struggled. It will not do. My feelings will not be repressed. You must allow me to tell you how ardently I admire and love you. Give a girl an education and introduce her properly into the world, and 10 to 1 but she has the means of settling well, without further expense to anybody. To come with a well-informed mind is to come with an inability of administering to the vanity of others, which a sensible person would always wish to avoid. It isn't what we say or think that defines us, but what we do. For what do we live, but to make sport for our neighbors, and laugh at them in our turn?